On Wednesday, Peloton shares plummeted by 15% because the company had to recall its Tread and its Tread Plus models for safety concerns. There have been numerous complaints of injuries, and unfortunately, a six-year-old child got pulled under the tread and died. Now, this is obviously not a very positive or fun video to be making because it's pretty hectic, but I thought there were some important lessons for companies and for investors in this story, so that's why I'm making the video. My name is Cairo. Now let's dive in to what went down with this Peloton product recall. So here we've got a video which shows that the treadmill can be dangerous. It's a kid playing. Luckily, this kid wasn't hurt at all, actually. Playing with the ball and boom, gets sucked under the treadmill. That's pretty awful. Luckily, sister runs to get some help and the kid wasn't hurt. So it's pretty clear to see that treadmills can be dangerous. The Peloton treadmill can be dangerous, and that is why they've had to recall the model. But is it just the Peloton treadmill that is dangerous, or are all treadmills dangerous? So let's just have a look at some statistics to see what kind of injuries and deaths have happened treadmill related over the last couple of years. So looking at this Wired article, the Consumer Product Safety Commission, they'd actually warned Peloton about the safety concerns. And they have also told the Washington Post that there were 22,500 treadmill related injuries in the US in 2019. So clearly treadmills are dangerous. Most parents would know that treadmills are dangerous and you should keep your kids and your pets away from them. But there were also 17 deaths involving treadmills in the 2 years between 2018 and 2020. So why is this such a problem for Peloton? Well, it could be because of their very clever and smart marketing. They're becoming a household brand. They're very smart with their tech integrations, and they only sell this one treadmill. It's not like other big manufacturers or big conglomerates who are selling loads of different SKUs. Peloton is just selling this treadmill. Now, with such a big recall, obviously there are going to be ramifications, and those ramifications were that the share price took quite a nosedive on Wednesday. If we check out the chart here, you can see that's Wednesday when it took a big drop from 98 all the way down to about 83. So what could Peloton have done differently? How could they have handled this situation better? Well, they were warned by the CPSC last month about the potential dangers of the treadmill, and Peloton refuted those claims. I do like, though, that their CEO, John Foley, has come out and issued a statement saying that they made a mistake. We should have engaged more productively with the CPSC's request from the outset. For that, I apologize. So Peloton had to recall its Tread Plus and its Tread models, but for different reasons. So the Tread Plus was recalled because of the risk to pets and to children getting stuck underneath the treadmill. But the Tread, the smaller model, was recalled because the touch screen at the front of the treadmill had been reported to be getting loose and having danger of falling down and hurting someone. So pretty unfortunate for Peloton to be having to recall both models, especially as they're very highly priced items and they would affect their sales forecasts going into the next few quarters. It's worth noting that the treadmills only account for a small percentage of the company's revenue so far, which is mainly still the bikes that they are known and famous for, but the treadmills will be a huge growth driver in the future. So what should Peloton do to make their treadmills more safe? They already have a safety warning on them saying that these treadmills are only for use of people age 16 and over. Fitness blogger DC Rainmaker over here, he's got a couple of cool suggestions about how Peloton could make their treadmill safer. Essentially, he is saying that they could have some form of software lock, just how your phone goes onto auto lock when you're not using it. It could be the same thing that if the adult steps off of the treadmill, it automatically auto locks and doesn't start going again, so that if there was a kid in the room, the kid couldn't go and get like stuck under the treadmill when the adult wasn't paying attention, wasn't watching. That's one of the alternatives. What some other treadmills do is they put a safety bar at the end so that a kid or pet wouldn't actually be able to get stuck underneath. But all in all, it's still got moving parts. It's still going to be dangerous. If a small kid gets on a treadmill and falls off, they could break an arm. They could hurt themselves terribly, regardless of whether Peloton have that bar protecting it from the outside. Again, I think the safety lock is probably a really smart move, but lots of other treadmills don't have those safety locks. So regardless of these safety measures, it's still important that the parents keep the small children and their pets away from the treadmill. Most treadmills are dangerous. There have been other injuries with other brands and other treadmills. It's just that Peloton specifically focus on their stationary bike. They're quite a household name now, and they've come out with heavy marketing behind the treadmill. And it's just one SKU, so it's easier to pinpoint the fault on that one model. Overall, I think it's a good idea that Peloton has recalled these treadmills, and it will improve their overall image with the public, because them saying, hey, our treadmills are safe, when the CPSC was saying, actually, no, there's an issue here, doesn't look so good, not for the consumer and also not for investors. So I still firmly believe that Peloton will do well as a company going forward. They've already done so well with their stationary bike, and they have the opportunity to fix these issues with the treadmill and move forward from here. If you found this video helpful, please crush that like button. That will be a big help to the channel. And while you're down there hitting that like button, you can click the link for Webull. They're giving away 2 free stocks valued up to $1,800. You might even get a free stock off Peloton. Now, the algorithm thinks you're gonna like this video next, so check it out. I'll see you in there, and let's hustle together.